All right. Hello, everybody. Let's start warming up with some good mornings. Hinging from the hip, keeping the back nice and flat. Abs tight, pulling that belly button up to your spine. Legs straight, but some bend in the knee, pushing up the heels. Now keep it down here and just pulse into a low squat. Open up that chest, keep the chest lifted. Pull the shoulders down and back and breathe nice and deep. All right, lunging side to side. Nice deep lunge through the heel, pushing up through the heel. Again, keep that chest lifted. Breathing deep, getting a little bit deeper into each lunge. And now we're gonna go into some reverse lunges with a shoulder press. Using that kettlebell, if you don't have a kettlebell, you can use a dumbbell. I'm using right here a 20-pound kettlebell. So I lunge back with the same leg that I'm gonna do the shoulder press up. We're doing 40 seconds of exercise, 20 seconds of rest. So with this exercise, I'm actually doing about 4 in one hand and then switching the leg and the hand until the 40 seconds are over. And now we take that 20 second break. Grab your sips of water. We're gonna be heading into shoulder tap planks. So getting into that plank, hands underneath the shoulders, body in a nice straight diagonal lying, squeezing the glutes, pulling the abs up towards the sky. You're gonna tap the opposite shoulder with the opposite hand, keeping that head in line with your spine. The closer you bring your hands together, the easier this is gonna be. And if you can bring your feet out a little bit wider to widen the base, that will also help protect any pain you may be getting in your back. And as always, just take a break if you need it. Now moving up, we're gonna grab the heavier kettlebell. I'm using a 35-pound kettlebell here. And we're gonna go into a curtsy lunge. So you're gonna hold that kettlebell in a goblet squat hold. And you're gonna take the right leg and then the left leg, one at a time, lunging back and behind the opposite leg. So when you're pushing up through the heel again, feeling it in the glute and the outside of the thigh, and also squeezing up with that opposite inner thigh. Abs tight, shoulders pulled down and back, breathing nice and deep. Again, 40 seconds on, 20 seconds of rest. We are doing this 3 times through. So 3 exercises, 3 times through, will be our first circuit. Keep that curtsy lunging going. Great job, set the kettlebell down. Short break time. Catch your breath, grab a drink. Towel off. That's usually what I do about here, especially during these hot summer months, losing lots of extra hydration through your sweat. So make sure you drink extra water and come back, grab that kettlebell, and we are going to go into those reverse lunges with that shoulder press. Again, 40 seconds on, breathing nice and deep, about 4 and 4. So you can do 4 in one hand, switch, and hit that other side. Always exhaling on the part that seems harder, that concentric and eccentric movement. Inhale back, exhale, push up. And the most important thing to remember, as always, is just to keep breathing. All right, set that kettlebell down. 20 seconds off. Going down into that plank, getting ready for that next 40 seconds. Plank shoulder taps. And here we go. Get up, hands underneath the shoulders. Tighten up the glutes. Contract the core, pulling that belly button up to the sky. Again, to make it a little bit easier, you can widen out the base So take your feet a little bit wider apart. Try not to rock your hips from side to side. I know it gets challenging. You can see me doing it here a little bit too. But just really be conscious and aware of trying to keep your hips stabilized and your shoulders squared up to the floor. Almost done. And relax. All right, again, great job. Get up, grab that drink of water. You have your 20 seconds off. Walk it out. Get prepped up for that next round of curtsy lunges. Grab that kettlebell. Some people call it kettlebell. Whatever. Whoopsies. It's all right. You lose your balance. You remember to just get back up, reset. So much of the balance comes from your core. So again, pulling in that core, the stronger you can make your core, the better it will be to really work on your balance. And also, these curtsy lunges are really working our glute muscles. And glute muscles are so important to back protection and that core strength as well for back protection. So build those glutes, strengthen that core. Great job. Set the kettlebell down. 20 seconds off again. Sip water. I'm working out here right in front of the mighty Lake Michigan. And you can't really see the view today, but oh, it was just a beautiful sunny day. SS Badger came in while I was working out. All right, guys, this will be our final round of this segment. So reverse lunges into shoulder press. When you lunge back, you want that front knee to not be going over the toe. So the front leg should be bent in about a 90 degree angle. Step back nice and deep. If you can, try to get that back leg knee to the floor. I don't quite get there. I've got a few knee issues. So this works great for me. I'm still really working my glutes and my quads. And then getting that second upper body lift in there with the shoulder press. Breathing deep, core tight, almost there. And nice job, set it down. Grab a drink. Preparing once again for that plank shoulder tap. Setting up. Now, if at any time it's just too much to be on your feet, full plank, just drop down to the knees. That's fine. You'll want a mat. I didn't have a mat today, so I wasn't going to drop to my knees. I was all right, though. I was feeling good in the core. But as you can see, get up, do a down dog stretch, just anything to kind of stretch it out and get right back into it. But keep going. You're almost there. Almost there, almost there. Breathing deep. Squeeze the glutes, squeeze the glutes. And you're done. Great job. Stretch it out here. You can sit back. You can sit back at a child's pose. We have got another set of curtsy lunges. So grab a sip quick. One more 40-second round. Grab that kettlebell up. Goblet squat. Or I'm sorry, goblet hold. And here we go, reverse curtsy lunging. Now, the thing to remember with a curtsy lunge is even though we are bringing that back leg behind at an angle, we are trying to keep our hips and shoulders squared to the front. So it's not like we're turning corner to corner. Great job. Push up through that front heel. All right, guys, we are moving into the next section. You're gonna grab your 20-pound kettlebell and we're going into Cossack squats. So you're gonna take a nice wide stance and kind of during that warm-up, it's the same idea here. You're just lunging deep side to side. The leg that is straight, you can pick up that toe and the leg that bends in the lunge. Get nice and deep, but don't let the knee come over the toe. Again, abs tight. Try to keep your shoulders lifted as high as possible. And you're done. 40 seconds on, 20 off. The next exercise, we're going to be grabbing, again, that same size kettlebell. If you want to challenge yourself a little bit more, you can grab the heavier kettlebell. And we're going to go into alternating rows. So you're going to hinge from the hip forward. Keep your back nice and straight, abs tight. And you're going to row that kettlebell back, gliding your elbow up your side. It's straight back, pulling that elbow up to the sky. Head forward, breathing deep, turning to the front here so you can see what this looks like from the front. Breathing nice and deep, exhaling as you pull back, inhaling down. Again, pull that core in, don't let the back arch. We're at 40 seconds, we're almost there. Then we'll get our 20 second break. Keep going, elbow pull back and you're done, set it down. 20 seconds off, grab a drink, walk it out. If you have to stretch a little bit, just stretch the arms. We are going into glute bridges. So we're gonna have to get down on the ground and grab the kettlebell. I grabbed the heavier one here. I went to the 35. I'm gonna set it right on top of my lower abdomen. My feet are hip width apart and I'm pushing up through the heels and down. When I get to the top of that bridge, I really squeeze and contract the glute and then lower down, inhaling and exhaling. If it's too much weight here, set the weight down, grab a smaller weight, or even just do them without. That's fine too. You can do these glute bridges without the weight, especially if you're just a beginner. Well, not just a beginner, but if you're a beginner. Again, push up through the heels, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze at the top, and back down. We're almost there. Again, this is 40 seconds. Nice job. Woo! Come on up. Taking your break. Stretch out whatever feels like it needs to be stretched. Grab a drink. We're going back into those Cossack squats, side to side. Hold it in that goblet hold again. And really lunge just side to side. My hips, my hip flexors, I really have to work on those. Those get tight. So sometimes these are a little bit challenging for me. I really have to think about sticking my tush back towards that window, towards my back wall here. Keeping the chest lifted and always pushing up through the heel of the bending leg. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Great job. Almost there. Again, we're doing those 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off. I also grabbed a heavier kettlebell that time. I went up to the 35, so that one, you can tell I was definitely more challenged there. Walk it out. Sip, sip, sips of water. Going into those alternating rows. I also went up in the kettlebell here. I'm up at a 35 pound, so these get more difficult, as you can see. But again, keep that elbow tucked into your side. Pull straight back. Inhaling and exhaling. Nice job. I'm bending at the knees slightly, hinging forward from my hip, keeping my back flat. This gets to be a little tough here. This is heavy. This is heavy for me. Trying to relax through my neck. Pull back, pull back. Women, this is such a great exercise for us. As we get older, hormones definitely kick in and we tend to get that rounded shoulder anyway, but then of course, more sitting or typing jobs, things like that. So really, really important to do row type exercises. All right, we're back down on our backs going into glute bridges. So grab your weight, set it on top of your low abdominals. And press, let's go up and down, nice and slow, squeeze at the top, inhaling and exhaling. Nice job, keep going, 40 seconds. It goes pretty quick sometimes. Keep going, keep going. Strong glutes help a strong pain-free back. And you're done. Set it down. Roll it up. Grab a drink. I look out at the water. Here comes the boats. We have one more round to do here. Our third round in this segment. So back to those Cossack squats. Grab that kettlebell. All right, here we go into those Cossack squats. Last set here. You can either stay at that higher weight with your kettlebell or go down a little bit. The key here is to remember to have good form. So if the weight is too heavy where you're really compromising your form, it's not benefiting you. So make sure you have a challenging weight where by the end of that last 10 seconds, you are really, really burning in your thighs, but you can still perform the exercise with good form. Nice job, keep going. Try to keep that chest lifted to the best of your ability. Great job, set the weight down. 20 seconds off. Going into those rows, so get ready to set up the weights right between your feet. Alternating rows. Again, the key here is to have a flat back, tight core, and pull that arm straight up your side, gliding your elbow up the side of your rib cage. Inhale, exhale. Nice job. I switched here because it was just getting, to me, a little too light. I wanted to challenge myself again. It's great to have a good range, I would say at least 2 to 3 different size kettlebells for home gym workouts. Lots of different options out there. You can message me anytime. I can give you some ideas on different kettlebells to buy. Great job. Get your drink here. Got a little bit more time. Actually, no. That's right. We have more glute bridges. All right, so get set up. Get that weight on to your lower abdominals. And let's go. Up and down, glute bridges. It's not... Oh, just a quick up, down, up, down. All right, really squeeze, release. Squeeze and release. Inhale, exhale. Push your hips up as high to the ceiling as you can. Up through the heels. Lower it back down. Great job, almost done. 40 seconds on. And you're done. Awesome, good job. All right, you guys, this is our last round. We are going into the clean and press. So with the clean and press, you're gonna start with the kettlebell right between your feet. You're gonna grab it vertically and pull up with a swing and a thrust, keeping that elbow close to your side the entire time. You're not letting, see a couple times there, I let that kettlebell kind of flop. You don't want a huge flop, you just wanna pull. Keep that elbow as close to your side as you can, clean and press. So again, you're gonna be squatting, pulling, thrusting forward, and keeping that elbow close to your side. Good job, that was 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off. So the next exercise, we're gonna be going into a squat and a halo. These are tough, these burn. This is gonna get your heart rate up. All right, here we go into that squat halo. So holding the kettlebell reverse than the goblet hold. So the bell is actually facing up. You're gonna come down in a low squat. Try to keep your shoulders lifted. Your chest lifted, your shoulders back. And you're gonna circle that kettlebell around your head, bringing that bell to the nape of your neck when you bring it behind. Big circle around, alternating the direction each time you come around. This is a challenging one. If it's too hard to do in a squat, just stay standing upright in that vertical position and do the halo. But to make it more challenging, again, get down low in that squat. Nice job, set it down. Grab a drink, catch your breath. So the next exercise we're gonna be going into is I'm going to give you a couple options here and I'll show you. You can start in regular push-up position and do some push-ups. You can go into a modified plank and do your push-ups on your knees. Or you can forego the push-ups completely and just go into a regular plank like we did in that first round. All right, hands under shoulders. And we're going to do handcuff planks. So instead of doing shoulder taps, you're going to take one arm and place it at the small of your back. And then take the other hand and place it at the small of your back. So in this section, I'm kind of showing you a couple different options. I also will always kind of come up in a down dog stretch, to stretch out and just kind of reset. All right, so I showed you the three different ways that you could do that. Didn't do anything on my knees today because I did not have a mat on that hard floor. So let's get ready to go into our second round. You're gonna get that kettlebell. Now we're gonna do that clean and press with the opposite arm that we did it the first round through. So if you did it with your right arm the first time, we're now doing it with our left. Pull up, oops, flipped it a little bit too high there, but up and hold. So it's elbow close in, tucked to your side, and just let it release and flip right to the outside of that upper bicep. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Really use the legs and the glutes to power up into that clean. So it's just the clean here, not the clean and press, just the clean. Clean through, kettlebell clean. Nice job, abs tight, and set it down. Grab a drink, catch your breath. We're going into that low squat, into the halo. Kettlebell facing up, hold it close to your chest. We're going into 40 seconds again here. We're taking our 20 seconds off, 40 on, let's go. And up, squat opposite direction, and back up. Sweeping that bell behind your neck, right at the nape of your neck and up. Getting caught in my pony messy bun there, as you can see. Down, low, push up through the heel. Nice job, breathe nice and deep. Great. Almost there. And up. Down, around, and up. Again, alternating each time. Great job. Set it down. We are going into that plank. I'm going to be just doing the handcuff alternating plank this time through. Feel free to add a push-up in between each alternating handcuff. So getting set, hands under the shoulders. Ready to push it up into that full plank. Proper plank again is always a nice straight diagonal line throughout your body from your head all the way down to your toes. Pull the core in nice and tight, squeeze your glutes. And again, you can see as I'm just pulling an opposite hand behind, placing it on the small of my back, handcuff plank. Again, you can add a push-up in between each one if you want, modified on your knees. That's the awesome thing about exercise is there's always a way to modify it. So it's challenging, but it's not going to injure you or frustrate you to the point of not wanting to come back and take care of your body. It's a journey, not a destination, you guys. Great job. Thank you. I hope you guys can check out my website. Join me live for my Bar Above classes every Monday at 9 a.m. Have an awesome day, everybody. Please like, comment, and subscribe.